problem that Tennessee presents on the offensive glass. Their length, their athleticism, their size on the interior. You get them to miss the shot, they just pursue the offensive board.
For three, just off the back iron. Goss coming up with the rebound. And then Lockett's able to get the one-hander. Horston, good defense as she is shut down in the lane, but that left Jackson open. No NCAA appearances. Now Lockett, there's some of that ability. Goss, Hollingshed in the game already. The Georgia transfer. Jumper by Jasmine Powell.
But she wants them to be contested jump shots. Getting out there, getting a hand up is critical.
Wired with a terrific pass into McConowitz. Forcing back-to-back turnovers. Horston into Hollingshed, and they do have an advantage.
And that's about the fourth shot that Toledo's had that has just rattled in and out.
Reminds me of some of the Stanford shots last night.
Yeah, Stanford really had a hard time. As Jillian Hollingshed gets the tip in. The boards, such a concern for Tricia Cullup. Hollingshed, it's great position.
Nice dish to find Cook from McConowitz. Final 30 seconds of the first quarter, and a big smile for Sarah Puckett with that win over St. Louis, 25-0, pardon me, at first round at home. Pam Ward and Stephanie White joining you in this second round matchup.
Is going to dare Tennessee to knock down shots from distance. Caroline.
The second quarter on the bench, she's got two personal fouls. She's their leading scorer and the MAC player of the year. Much needed from Jada Jansen, who scored 17 off the bench in the win against Iowa State. Why not, right? She just hit one from out there. Strickland saw Walker out of the corner of her eye. And then the turn by Jackson. Pulling it up and then threw it to Horston. Now Horston delivers. Lockett. She can heat it up.
You're going to see Lockett look to do a little bit more of that coming off of those on-ball screens, off of handoffs. A little bit more than mid-range pull-up. Sometimes getting too deep with that look. And Jordan Horston knocks down the three. Tia Jackson, after coming back from missing those couple of games, came off the bench and was incredibly coachable. I mean, this is a group that you can tell is really well connected. And it could go one way or another when you play a schedule as tough as they did. And, you know, they were exposed, but they figured it out.
Nice. Hollingshed, she's got six. Hollingshed. All the way across court. Powell. Terrific move to the basket. You see the three. Lockett able to get a tough one. Jordan Walker, her second of the game. For the Lady Vols. The threes are falling tonight. The rebound falls into the hands of McConowitz. Now Lockett can show you some of that skill, but look at that terrific block by Franklin. The double, terrific pass out of it, and a chance for a three-point play. Tennessee shooting 46%, including 7 of 13 from three. Make it 8 of 14.
State didn't have the size, didn't have the speed, the athleticism that Tennessee has at all positions and coming off the bench.
Iowa State and this Tennessee team, they are so different. And they are just plowing through right now. dribble here is Goss. Eric Goss, yes, and foul.
It was the ultimate point guard on a team that was really stacked.
Walker, boom.
Well, you certainly want to be peaking at the right time, but this is the best offensively that I've seen Tennessee play all season.
Major Jets. Pass is out. Kowitz. Knocks down the three. Garcia. Good job by Hollingshead because Garcia likes to fire it from there. And then the nice pass to Lockett. Lockett, nice hesitation.
Bested Tennessee earlier in the season.
Lockett, 452 career assists. That's a lot, but it's only good enough for tying for seventh in this program's history. Long range shot. A couple of threes in the game against Iowa State. The first round. Resiliency. Horsted. Too strong. Puckett. Puckett's having himself a game today. Is a very entertaining program.
You never know what's going to happen.
Especially with Taurasi, it's got to be on a delay, right? Hollingshead. Nice.
Virginia Hollingshead, a player.
Jackson showing her athletic ability, getting the ball, and then making it look easy.
She's really just getting herself back into physical shape as Makanowicz gets to the rim.
Jackson on the defense. And on the offense. Waning seconds in the third quarter. Powell puts a nice ball on it. 15 of 36, that's 42%, which is 11% more than their average coming in. Meyer giving it up to Konowitz. Cook has had all sorts of trouble. They just can't get anything going. Inside. Worsted. Turns. Scores.
Church of Hope said for a scholarship opened up and they were able to give it to Samuel Konowitz. But a local kid who wanted to stay close to home.
Rossford, Ohio, near Toledo. Against Iowa State. Yes, this is the team that took out the Cyclones who won the Big 12 tournament. It looked like Iowa State was peaking at the right time. The three-point shots continue to fall. That's Darby's turn. You were talking about Indiana possibly playing LSU in Greenville, but still some basketball to be played. Remember husband while she was going to school here at Tennessee. Another bucket for Wynn. One of her assistants, Coach Harper, able to get her reserves. Plenty of time. Hollingshead. Nailed it!
It's that three-point range we talked about.
Meyer going for an MBA. Wants to go into finance.
Yes.
Now, their team GPA was silly. But right now, they're just playing against one of the hottest teams in the country.
Okay, Kaya Wynn.
A force to be reckoned with in this NCAA tournament. On the way to Seattle. The Lady Vols. Sweet again.